In this quick start squeeze page guide, you're going to learn how to build a squeeze page from scratch using a free tool called MailerLite. Timestamps below, along with a link to check out MailerLite and apply for a free account. Just as a quick asterisk here, this is not for affiliate marketing, as your application will most likely get rejected. But if you have an actual business selling actual products or services, then MailerLite is definitely a good solution for you. So let's go ahead and jump into my screen here. You can see that we actually use MailerLite ourselves, and we get some pretty decent conversion rates. And I also want to show this not to brag, but just to show that you don't have to be super fancy with your landing page design. In fact, if I scroll down here, one of our worst performing landing pages is one of the templates that we used as opposed to the plain text one we are about to build. So let's go ahead and click on create a landing page here, and then we'll be able to give our landing page a name. So I'm going to call it F28 dividend report, and I'm just putting F28 so I know that this is an example and not an actual landing page. So I'll go ahead and click on save and continue here. And then MailerLite is going to ask us what list or group we want to add people to. So if you're doing this for the first time, you can just click on add group. And then whenever someone enters their name and email on your squeeze page, they're going to be added to this particular subscriber group. So I'm going to click cancel here, and I'm just going to choose one of our demo ones here, fresh fans. So whenever someone enters their name and email, they'll automatically be added to this group, and then you can automatically send emails. And what's really great about MailerLite is you can actually auto send emails on the free plan, unlike some other free plans out there. So that's why I am a huge, huge fan of using MailerLite. Of course, the downside is they don't really like affiliate marketing. Now, you have a lot of templates to choose from here. I went ahead and loaded all of them, and I'm just scrolling through them to show you, this is actually the template that performed really poorly for us, that you don't need to really stress over the design. So we're going to go ahead and click on select on the first one here. And it doesn't matter which one you click select on, because we are just going to immediately remove everything for our squeeze page. So we'll have to wait for MailerLite to load. Always takes forever. Still loading, waiting, still waiting.
1 eternity later.
All right, and after a good 15 or 30 seconds, depending upon your internet connection, the landing page will load. So they have all of these blocks here ready to go, but we're just going to click on actions in the top right and remove content blocks. So we'll type in remove. You don't have to do all caps. I don't know why I did that, but just adding extra work for myself. And then we're going to add blocks. Now, because we're doing a squeeze page and not a landing page, really for me, the only difference between a squeeze page and a landing page is going to be your testimonials and then not having bullet points. So since we're doing a squeeze page here, all we need is text. And then of course we need a form. So we'll click on the sign up form element here and click and drag it. We'll try again. There we go. Click and nope. And just kidding, second time's a charm here. So I'll go ahead and drop in our headline. And this is just one I quickly wrote. If you want to learn more about the copywriting behind your headlines, check out the links in the cards and the description to a video that walks through how to do the copywriting for that. So we'll go ahead and format our headline here. So I'm going to actually click out of this. And the first thing you want to do is change the format to heading one. And then of course we want to change the heading one. So instead of trying to make modifications here, we actually have more options if we click on settings, and then we change the headline element for the entire page. So I'm going to go ahead and change this to a different font here. And I like the font size, but the font color, let's go ahead and change this to blue. And then we're going to go ahead and center the font, and I don't want it to be bold. Come on, center the font. And for some odd reason, it's not censoring the font like I asked it to. So we'll have to come up here, click, and then do the align center for manually here. So what is important to note though with your headline is not to hit enter to try and make it two lines, because these landing pages or these squeeze pages are responsive. And so if you do this, it's gonna show up really weird on mobile. So just go ahead and however the words fall, just go ahead and leave it alone. It's not going to be a huge deal. It's much more important that the text looks good on all screen sizes. So now we have the second element here, which is going to be our image of our lead magnet and of course collecting that contact information. So let's go ahead and add our lead magnet image. I already have one uploaded here, about the dividends report, so I'll just go ahead and select it. If you want to learn more about putting together your lead magnet and how to actually create an image that looks similar to this one, I'll link up in the cards and the description to a full-blown lead magnet creation tutorial. I can say magnet right. Okay, so now, of course, you can see email and subscribe. It's pretty small. So what we can do is we can click and drag and make this smaller, although I like having it a maximum size, especially since we're not going to be putting very much more on this page. So once we click the element here to change the signup form, we can click on form, and then we're actually going to add a field. Now, I'm not a fan of asking for the name and email on a squeeze page. I think you really just need the email. However, because of the limitations of the design, we cannot force MailerLite to stack the buttons unless we have more than one form field, or I should say button. There's only one, the subscribe button here. So I'll go ahead and leave name and email alone, but I'll come over here to form settings, and for our call to action button, I don't want it to be red because red means stop, right? And we want to go. So we'll just go ahead and change this to a green. And then if we want to make the button size larger, what we have to do is change the button text size. So I'm going to bring this up to 24, and I'm going to bring it to the same font as I have the headline. So the general rule of thumb, two fonts across the entire page. If you have more than two fonts, then it starts to look a little messy. So I'm just going to be super basic here and have just two fonts. And of course, you can change how it's aligned, although I'll just go ahead and leave it as full width and right underneath the name and email here. Of course, you can change it to whatever you want here, but I'll go ahead and make it full width. We'll go ahead and change the hover color because it's set to red for some reason, and we'll just change it to a lighter green. And of course, you can actually change you can add custom colors if you'd like. So you can see here now we hover and it changes color. And we'll go ahead and change the font size of our inputs as well. So I'll click on input over here, and we'll change it to the same font we've been using for everything else. And I'll leave the colors alone, and I'll bring this up to 18. So 18 for the input fields, and then 24 for the subscribe. And we'll form settings. We probably don't want it to say subscribe, so we'll say something like download now. There we go. And just like that, we have our squeeze page. Now, can you do a lot more with your squeeze page? Could you start adding bullet points, some customer testimonials, and of course, some legal disclaimer text at the bottom? Absolutely. But this is all it takes to put together a squeeze page. And as you saw at the beginning of this video, we get some pretty decent conversion rates with simple looking pages just like this. Are you going to win a design award? Absolutely not. But you're not out to win design awards. You are out to convert new people into email subscribers. So I will go ahead and click on save and publish here so we can see our completed page. Now, I did skip creating this success page, and so you can just at the top click on success page and reformat it to the way you want, but I want to go ahead and preview our live page here. So scrolling down, I do want to note that you should go ahead and add your tracking, like your analytics, your Facebook pixel. I recommend using Google Tag Manager, so a link up in the cards in the description to a playlist on that or video on that. And now we can just go ahead and click on save and continue. If you're using the free plan, you won't be able to use a custom domain. That's part of the downsides of not paying 10 bucks a month for the features. So we can go ahead and copy the URL and paste it into a new tab so we can see our squeeze page all set up and done. So that does it for creating your squeeze page. If you have any questions about MailerLite or setting up even more features, go ahead and comment below. I will also link up in the cards in the description to a video that takes a much deeper dive on how to actually create a landing page, a lot more elements. There's so much more you can do with MailerLite, but this is a great place to get started. If you do decide to sign up for MailerLite and upgrade to a paid plan in the future, we do receive a small commission as a way to help support this channel. So thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button for more marketing tutorials just like this one. And until the next, keep building the business you love.